What's like the number one tip that you would give of like going out about maybe doing that?
I think so. If supporting restaurants is in like your entire being, yeah. So I would say pick a number. Because so part of this is too, like I mentioned before, your food budget is gonna probably like be part credit card and part what's happening in like general bank account area.
Yeah.
So I would pick a number on what you're gonna be spending on the card every month and like do not go over it. So part of what happens when I'm structuring budgets is like the credit card is its own category because we know we're paying it off, but it's important to know what's actually going on that card and how that actually reflects in the overall budget. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Because you have a balance that you're paying off plus all this. Like, that's great that you're making a minimum payment, but if you keep putting stuff back on there every month, you're not really, you're kind of on the treadmill. You're not going to go anywhere.
Right. And I think the reason why I put that as number two is because it's actually a lot more. Because when it's normally the train of thought is, I have to put all my money towards debt. And like, that is the absolute thing that I like in my bones agree with. Because there are some authors out there that say things like, you can't live your life at all until all your debt's gone. But the reason why that author makes so much money is because people have to keep enrolling in the program because it's not sustainable. Because if you're telling me that I can't do something, I'm going to go do it anyway.
Yeah.
Like, that's just human behavior. So if you continue to keep yourself capped, you're going to burn out. So for me personally, I'm like, you know, I have a buffer in my account that it's like, okay, I know I need at least this, but there's this much extra for that moment that I just need to go get either a drink or an ice cream cone.